I actually am right now today filming something, and it's a secret, and so I can't tell you what it is, but it's going to be big. And do I want to promote it? Yes, but I can't because it's a secret. But I will soon enough.
I mean, I'll give you a spoiler. Like, I did all kinds of new stunts, and one of them, not only did I swallow an entire
bruh
of Chris Pontius's
bruh,
but I did it right in front of my father.
Oh my god!
Oh, wait, you just like took
bruh
the mouth or what?
He blasted a huge
bruh
a condom in the bathroom. He
bruh,
and then he tied it in a knot and brought it out and handed it to me in front of my dad.
See, this is
my dad.
Where? Go ahead. Yeah. Sorry. Go ahead. Say it.
Well, my dad's notoriously. I remember my dad was like, "Why is this the right thing to do?"
Yeah.
I said, "Dad, I'm not doing this to hurt you." He says, "You're not going to hurt me. You're going to piss me off."
What was the worst accident or stunt you've seen Bam take? You know, there was one stunt that it wasn't even a stunt. It was literally an accident that a lot of people aren't aware of. And he went to dive into this pond in the middle of Pennsylvania. And I don't even know if it was being filmed. And when he dove into it, he literally hit his rock and got like 18 staples in his head and he almost broke his neck, which would have paralyzed him forever. And that was really scary, just knowing that literally an accident, something that wasn't planned, could, in the blink of an eye, could change the rest of your life.
I saw a few of my friends' moms naked accidentally. One mom I saw naked twice, maybe three times. I mean, seeing naked, like really naked.
Yeah, right. Knoxville believes firmly that the older you get, the funnier it is.
I agree.
I don't 100%. Know. I think at a certain point it just gets kind of tough to watch. But hey, man, I don't mind a bit. And the one week that we were able to film, like the chemistry was there, the fucking footage, everything's worked out fantastically. So we were able to put together enough footage in that one week for the question marks to be answered. Plus, they got me a producer credit, which is kind of
yeah.
cool.
Oh, that's
cool. Second billing, it's Knoxville and Steve-O.
Oh, cool, man.
So I just said, hey, guys, I think I bring more to the table this time around. And this time I'm going to stay out of my own way and I'm going to do what my lawyer
let them do,
you know,
the
I'm gonna let my guy do what he does, you know. And so I extricated myself from the situation, and my lawyer did say this is fucking bullshit, you know. And then we kind of got into the standoff, so to speak, you know. And God, it was just really something else, man. I'd never really gone down that path. Mm-hmm. You know, where to find, like, how contentious, you know, how, like,
it's heartbreaking.
Sort of, you know,
isn't it heartbreaking?
Like, it's like, wow, like,
I know.
You know, it's like, wow, man, like when you're fighting over money, like, because we're not negotiating with the parent, with the movie studio. You know, already the production company.
They gave you a budget.
The production company, which is Knoxville and Spike Jones and Jeff Tremaine, like, they've got their deal with the studio,
with
Paramount Pictures. And so now it's up to them to
delegate
to deal with us. So anything that we get comes out of their shit. And so that's what I came to learn. It's like, wow, they're really fucking pretty serious about digging in their heels and getting real fucking heavy over this. And
the good thing is, you know, they can't do it without, like, if someone hey, there's a new Jackass, but there's no Steve, I'm like, I'm not going.
It got to a point where my lawyer even was like, wow, you know, like, we got a little better, and you know, at this point I just can't advise you to pass on this.
Yeah.
You know. Whoa. and so I was like, hey guys, it's all I needed was my guy to say the word go. And so I don't think that I got anything really like substantial in the way of like,
I think it's a respect thing.
Yeah, I think
it's almost that. You know what I'm saying?
And whatever. It was overall, it was a wildly uncomfortable process. You know, like, and it is kind of heartbreaking when it's like when you're bros. But you know, I just come to learn that's the nature of the world. Fuck it. You know,
especially
and
show business, right?
Yeah.
And fuck. The drop kicks were from Bam to me. Has taken place many different times in many different places in many different parts of the world. Most of them that have taken place, I was pretty much in a fog, in a daze, in a blur, under heavy influence of drugs and alcohol to help eliminate the pain that ensued after I get a fucking drop kick to the face or the head or what have you.
What up, CJ Holiday? It's Bam Margera here, and I've been good, chilling in Florida. Got a fitness trainer. I'll be out here till the 20th, but still no word on Jackass because of COVID. So don't know about that. And what's the most complicated trick I've done? Probably a nollie full cab nollie flip on the mini mega ramp at my house. That was hard as shit to do. It took me almost 2 hours to land, but I got it. It's in Elementality, the skate video. Yeah, man. Cheers.